So, today I would like to talk about my trip to Laos, which is now already 2 months ago. I would like to summarize my experience. I actually only spent 3 full nights in Laos. From these 3 nights, I only spent 1 night in a real bed. And actually there are 5 nights because I was traveling from Vietnam to Laos. I slept in the bus, and also from Laos to Thailand where I slept in the bus. So there were 5 nights, of which I only slept 1 in a real hotel, or I mean in a real bed. I think this is not the average experience of a tourist. There was also a lot of things going wrong during our trip. I mean our trip, because I was traveling with a friend from Germany who joined me, since we were invited to a wedding in Thailand. And she came to fly to Vietnam to see me, and from there we traveled to Laos over the border from Hanoi to Luang Prabang. Yeah, Luang Prabang is not a capital, but it's a wonderful city. Laos itself, it's really amazing because of the nature. So if you love nature, you're gonna love Laos. It's the whole country is like jungle. So it's almost like the rainforest of Southeast Asia. I think it's the best like nature in Southeast Asia, I would say, in terms of woods. Yeah? You don't have ocean, but you have lakes and woods and small mountains, so it's really, really nice. Also animals, a few. So anyway, our trip wasn't going so well. We slept was a night bus from Hanoi, and when we arrived in Luang Prabang, unfortunately we could not go to our hotel. I had the address of our hotel, which is in Luang Prabang, but I asked at the bus station, how can we get a taxi to this hotel? And I don't know if they thought something wrong. I said, no, this hotel is not here. It is far away. Yeah? You booked something wrong. Unfortunately, I didn't have mobile internet. We also arrived very late. So we decided, okay, we just take the taxi to the city center. And in the city center, we just went to one hotel. And yeah, everything was booked in the whole city because it was Tet Holiday or Chinese New Year, which is celebrated not only in China but also in Vietnam and Laos. So there were lots of tourists. Everything was extremely expensive, and there was nothing available on that night. So they offered us for $20 to sleep on the floor. So we slept on the floor in the hotel lobby after we arrived. The next day, when we had internet, we actually found that they gave us false information and that this hotel is actually in Luang Prabang. So we could have gone to a hotel, but we didn't know. So yeah, anyway, we slept on the floor, and then we thought, okay, what are we going to do the next day? Everything was very expensive, so we had to pay 60 euro, 70 US dollars, which is very expensive for Laos, to get a hotel room for one night in Luang Prabang. Yeah, because again, Chinese New Year. yes, so we had at least one night where we could recover. We took some day trips to local waterfalls, hiking. It was really, really amazing, beautiful nature. You could go swimming in the lake, which I didn't do because it was cold, but my German friend did it. And there were also like sun bears. They had like a sanctuary for those bears. It was interesting to see. Also the food, it's actually not expensive, it's quite cheap. It's slightly more expensive than Thailand, I would say, Laos. But the country itself is not very developed. But it's very, very touristy. So the culture is also very similar to Thailand, lots of rice dishes. But also the food was super delicious. They have spring rolls and all kinds of stuff. Yeah, we also did a river cruise in Luang Prabang, which was very nice, a sunset cruise. I also enjoyed that one. It was actually run by a foreign company, not by locals, but it was nice. And then, after one night spending in a hotel, we took another night bus to Vientiane, which is the capital. Vientiane, there's not much nature, but they have more historical things to see. There is like this gate. I don't know much about this the history of Laos, but yeah, we saw some stuff. As well, the highlight of the trip was this Buddha Park, which is maybe 1 hour away from the city center. So we took the bus to there, and there were so many Buddhas. It's amazing to take photos, flowers. Yeah, we really enjoyed it there. We also met some other tourists, like Japanese, we had good conversations with. So all in all, it was quite short. So we didn't even spend a night in Vientiane. We arrived in the morning after the bus, went to a hotel, gave them some money to take care of our luggage. And then we just explored the city, went to the Buddha Park. And at night, we took another night bus to Thailand. So it was very, very stressful. I'm really sorry for my German friend, because it's not usually that stressful when I travel. But these days we had a really tight schedule because of the wedding, and we're running late in Vietnam. Since we couldn't get the early night bus, there were a few nights where no bus going to Laos because of the holidays. So we had to delay our schedule, and that's why we were so tight in schedule, and we had to rush. And that was a little bit unfortunate. And then after going to Thailand, another unfortunate thing is what happened, that my friend's luggage was missing after we arrived in Bangkok. I'm so sorry, so much stress. The first 4 or 5 nights not sleeping in a real bed, and then this. Yeah, luggage, we arrived, and where's the suitcase? It wasn't just there. Somebody must have stolen it. I mean, I traveled so many countries, and I've never had something happen like this. And my friend never traveled, and then she's so unlucky with this thing. I feel really, really sorry for her. There was a lot of stress. We just arrived in Bangkok, went to the police station, went to the bus company. She had problems with the insurance. By the way, she's still claiming to get the money back, and she was not lucky. So the insurance say, oh, you have no proof. Because of course the bus, you don't get a proof for your luggage. It's not like an airplane. So probably she won't get the money back either from the insurance. It's really, really sad. So unlucky. I feel so sorry for her. I hope we could travel again one day and have a much better experience than this. Anyway, all in all, Laos was a very nice country. But because I was traveling with her, I was not staying with locals like I used to do. Like, we didn't stay at Airbnb or Gautam used to spend in the hotel, so we couldn't really connect with the local culture. So I don't know what the real culture would be, but I expect it to be more like Thailand. To just meet locals on the street or from the hotel, but this is not a real experience. So that's why when you travel, I always recommend don't stay in hotels. Hostels are also good to meet other travelers, but it's still not the real experience. So couch surfing or Airbnb, like Airbnb staying in a guest house, this staying in a guest room in the house, this is the real experience, because then you live with the locals, you see how they live, and this is the best way of traveling. So anyway, Laos is a great country. Visit there, and I hope I can see it again and have more time and a much better experience than this year. Alright, thanks for watching.